the general consensus was that I need a dog for my videos, but I do have these guys. And this guy, who kind of looks like a shaggy dog right now. So we are stuck with them for now. For today's episode, we are going to focus on my journey with my Ren form. And yes, it has been an adventure. But let's go back to when I was 8 years old and look at that form. Somehow, over the years, I decided that I wanted to start running on my toes, which led to a lot of injuries. And so that meant that last March, I took Adam aside and I'm like, okay, you've got to help me here. And that was the start of me fixing my run form. Of course, I sent the videos to Tara, who is also an expert in this area, and she did this huddle gait analysis that clearly showed a few things. I was landing too far in front of my body. I was definitely landing on my toes. And just in general, there were a lot of things that I could fix. I didn't want to get to Kona and think that I left any extra time out there, so I switched to the Hokas because they are considered to have more endurance and are good for races, 5K all the way to ultras, and seem to be a little bit wider than the other carbon-plated shoes.
The Nikes are very narrow and I have a very wide foot, so I didn't think that that would be a great fit for me. And I really like the Hokas. So I went home to face a storm.
So I was practicing and I was getting better and I was getting faster. I was also increasing my volume. I slowly had built it up from 60, 70, 80, 90 to 100 kilometers a week pretty consistently. Of all the runs I did, I would keep 2 quality runs per week. So 1 speed work, 1 longer, sort of at the top of aerobic threshold / tempo. December 2020, I decided to see if all this work was helping, so I ran a 5K time trial with the hopes of breaking 19 minutes. I enlisted the help of Warren, who paces all the school cross-country meets, and he paced me, but I was still mostly running on my toes, so I was getting a lot of speed, but there's still work to be done with technique.
That's it. Looking good. Looking 342. Good stuff. Stay on him. Lean forward. What we do in the darkness.
We'll come light out right. So next step, I guess, was I watched a lot of run videos of Paula Finley, Heather Jackson, just over and over and over again. And I watched some 10K races and some other runners. I just watched a lot of runners and tried to absorb all of that and really
try to focus on that when I was running, especially when I was running easy, because it's a lot harder to think about technique when you're also working really, really hard. But initially, I started thinking about proper technique and gave myself cues to really focus on landing more midfoot and a bit closer and underneath my body. And I think it helped. I felt I was finally ready to put my running to the test, so I set a date for a 10-mile race where I would try to break 4 minutes per kilometer. That was the goal, and I thought that if I could do that, it would put my estimated half marathon time at around a 1:24 high to 1:25 low, which would be a best time, and that would give me sort of the confidence that I needed to know that the run training was working, the technique work was working, and my running was coming back. So tenderly, and with my headphones on, as I fall asleep, you're my barricade from intruding dreams. But up in the distance, even in the dead of night, if we can make it to the morning, like I want to punch. So I went home to face a storm, and the thought of you keeps me warm. But up in the distance, even in the dead of night, if we can make it to the morning, we can get things right. It's been a tough go lately. I hate choosing sides. What we do in the dark. I was so incredibly grateful and happy that I had family and friends at the line and Tara there to pace me the whole way. My form still isn't perfect, but it has come a long way and I do feel strong, and I'm really excited to continue to put in the effort and continue to improve and work hard, and hopefully by the time races come back, it means my run will be even faster. Thanks for watching, and next time we will talk about how I get through the hard training sessions. What are my cues, and some of what the harder training sessions I do look like. I will see you next time.